Hey, Sorten.
So, before we go back to the levels we were new on, I have the character I happen to need for the one heart star I was missing on this area. So I think I'm just gonna try and start it here. Hey, Sun Gaming and James. I'm not sure if I can actually keep him through here, or if I need Pitch. Or, not Pitch, he is Pitch. If I need Kine at some point. But, ow. Do not eat my face. Uh-oh. That's bad. I didn't realize my health was so low. Hopefully I'll find some peely stuff. Aw, come on! It was... whatever. Where's a good place to get Pitch? They can get him, like, first or second area here. It's a good attack underwater. Basically nothing, I guess. Ow. Hey, Peyton. Yeah, there's Pitch. Okay. We should be in good shape now. I'm not gonna 100% before the end here, but I just wanted to get this one out of the way, because it requires a specific partner. I happen to have him anyway. Plus, it lets us clear the whole world. I gotta worry about HP, because if I get hit like I did there, I lose my burb. This is a burb level. I like how he appears behind me for some reason. Just to make sure that I take damage, even if I time my attacks right. What is up with that? Oh, for Pete's sake! He doesn't even... Oh, whatever. It makes sense for the attacks to suck underwater, but still. Especially a fire attack. I forget if you actually do need to get Kine, or if... Oh. Oh. Okay, we legitimately do need Kine to actually continue on. Lego gives us Kine and then immediately dumps us out into a place where Kine is useless. I think this is the one where you need to open up a pathway, isn't it? Yeah. Aw, crap, I had fire and I gave it away. Is there fire somewhere around here? I need fire and then rock. Yeah, I remember this little puzzle. I don't remember exactly how to solve it. But I'm pretty sure both pieces we need are in here. Yeah. Hello, friend. Hey, BP. And sure enough, I am dropping a few frames, but it's just 5%, which is... the usual at this point. Alright, so we can clear those out. But then I need rock. I think there's a rock. I think there was rock on this side, is how this works. Here's rock. Come here. Alright, now we can bring over Kine. Who isn't even the one we need, but he lets us get the partner we need. I guess this is one of the more involved of the earlier puzzles. Tesla Grad? I think I have that. I followed the developer for that, but I haven't played it myself. There's always more games to play. I was just playing Moo Cartographer. Just a bit ago. It's really cool. It's half off, so it's only $2.50 on Steam right now. It's basically this thing where you use, like, an alien cartography interface, and you try to find, like, temples and stuff. It's really cool. Alright, yeah, this is the part where we need Kine. I forget exactly where we need to go. But somewhere around here, we'll find Pitch again, and we have to show him to his little girlfriend. I think he's in here. Yep. Hey, Pitch. Look at those little burb legs. Best legs. The artist for the game mentioned it rained a lot, so you bought it. Video game rain is pretty legit. My favorite rain, like, it's so simple but so effective, is the rain in Harvest Moon SNES. That is a fantastic... I should stream that sometime just for a chill stream. That is a fantastic game to just chill out with. I do wish... Has somebody made a ROM hack for Harvest Moon SNES where the time limit is removed? It seems like it would be a fairly simple thing, and it would improve the game so significantly. Like, it's really frustrating that the game ends after 2.5 years. And there's so many things you can, like, just barely get done in time. Especially if you don't know exactly what to do the entire time. Like, there's that money tree. I mean, it's not a real money tree. But I still enjoy growing stupid crap like that. I think I brought this up in a stream, like, a year or two ago. And nobody was aware of such a thing. But it's so obvious, but I don't know. Maybe it's harder than I would think to fix it, but I don't know. I don't know assembly. Sick knows assembly, but he does Genesis stuff. You told me it was you. Of course I don't give you another shout out. You only get one shout out. I'm stingy with my shout outs. That was a shout. That is your shout out. Oh, you got Rebirth. Yeah, I saw you mention that on Discord. Is this his mom, or like... She's very large. Very thick burb. Thick burb and small burb. Which is your favorite burb, chat? They're both very good burbs. They're good burbs, Brent. But yes, we must go. I don't even know why I'm going for the one-ups. I have 25. Found exact pop the headphones I'm wearing under my futon. I don't know where they came from. Alright, we have to fight the boss again to do this. Oh man, I have the worst freaking power for this. Which, actually, the power is actually so bad that... Oh. You can't leave bosses in this game, apparently. I'd forgotten about that. Oh well. Started with the SNES. I mean, the SNES one is the simplest by far, but the later ones are kind of too complicated to not, like, in not a good way. Like, they're just really complicated and really slow. Like, Back to Nature, or A New Beginning, the 3DS one is so slow, and it has, like, the entire first year is a tutorial, and that's, like, many, many hours of gameplay. And there's no way to skip it! It's just, you know, you have to play the whole first frickin' year, and you unlock nothing. And it's very annoying. Oh, come on. Yeah, just go ahead and give me your worst possible pattern, thank you. There we go. Okay, now he's gone. Oh. Okay. Well, I'll get him with a rock. Or he'll get me with a rock. Get him! Yes! I like how he still explodes, even when we get the friendship, you know. Oh yeah, 1610 is pretty... That's like a weird, like, laptop one, isn't it? Oh, do I go into this or... Oh, there we go. Most ROM hacks were left unfinished. Speaking of Harvest Moon SNES, somebody was working on like a sort of remake for TI-83, and it worked pretty well. TI-83, the calculator, by the way. So that was pretty impressive. So this is another one of those. Ow. Yeah, this is another one of those flower levels. Like I said, every world, I think, starts with a flower level. I'm not sure if the last world does. This is your first time watching Kirby? That's always kind of surprising to see. Ow. Yeah, Harvest Moon SNES is really good. It starts off limited. I mean, it's supposed to, though. But I would recommend at least playing a year's worth of stuff on it. I forgot Rick can bounce on enemies. He's... Oh, wait, can he? I thought he did back there. Pokemon Ruby Harvest Moon Edition. I just happened to find the... Oh, you can... The arrows hurt you just being in the ground. Alright, those things are like non-scarfy scarfies. They're piggies. They're parfies. Alright, this one's kind of disturbing. Kirby's like face explodes outwards into spikes. And Nago is horrified. Nago's like, this is not right. This is a demon child I am holding. Kirby's one of my favorite Nintendo properties, and favorite properties in general. Yeah, Kirby is notable for being one of Nintendo's, like, it's probably the game that has had the least, like, the best ratio of good to bad series. Like, even including spin-offs, Kirby's never really had a bad game. Like, mainline Nintendo games you can usually count on to be good, but spin-offs, can be pretty iffy. It's kind of the nature of spin-offs. But with Kirby, they kind of always find a decent thing to focus on spin-offs. So, auto-scrolling. Looks like most Harvest Moon hacks are called True Love Edition? What? Oh, speaking of Harvest Moon and love, that's one of the things that I really do not enjoy in most recent Harvest Moon games. In the early ones, you know, marriage was simple and not very, like, interesting, but it didn't... Oh. What was that guy named? Bottomon. Bye, Bottomon. He's gonna get smished. Yeah, I love the characters' face... Or the... Just watch the faces. The faces are very good in this game. That's right, Parker.
Yes, they are. Yes. Hi. What do you want?
Yes, they look so betrayed and horrified when you switch chick, pick the other one. Epic Yarn. Epic Yarn isn't bad, but it's definitely not the first one I would recommend that you play. Probably Kirby Superstar or Superstar Ultra. Return to Dreamland is great too, or Robobot, or Triple Deluxe. Ow.
Parky, please.
You're gonna get allergies all over me. Oh, right, the Pitch collects things in this form, which is really neat. Parky, would you sit down? Please sit down. Not there. Please do not obscure the thing. Wait. I think I've done a bad thing. I think I need broom for this. Or clean, I think it's called. No, get down! Okay. Oh yeah, back to what I was saying about Harvest Moon. Yeah, the getting married takes so freaking long. I was trying in a Rune Factory, which I mean, it's not Harvest Moon, but you know, it kind of is. And it just took for freaking ever. It was more grind-heavy to get a wife than it was to beat the RPG portions of the game. Which, you know... If you out-grind a JRPG, you're kind of doing something horribly wrong. I mean, it's not the most grind-heavy RPG, you know, it's light RPG mixed with, you know, farminess. But still. Also, look how there's just a little window or a doorway in the clouds, and that's fine. No, he actually has one of the weirder clean powers. Oh, I remember this one. Aw, this level is mean. So, the foreground is basically there to trick you. What? Pitch! Okay, so Bitch apparently does not clean those. We need to clean the flowers. Rune Factory 1 for DS. Chief, do you recommend playing it? I played Rune Factory Frontier. I definitely... It's a good series. Oh no, he stays dead. What? What do you mean? I think I need a certain partner. Oh, I remember, you need Rick. You need Rick because he gently dusts them off. Everything else kills them. I forgot about that. Just as I say that, somebody mentions that in chat. Yeah, thanks Firestorm, I remember though. Oh well. Yeah, Harvest Moon is way too complicated lately and it doesn't teach itself well. Like, it knows it's too complicated, so it starts, like, giving you features, like, over the course of, like, over a year, and... But it's just frustrating. Come here. Ice is oddly rare in this game. Ow. We see a lot more of it now in this world, and then in the next one. Parky. Yeah, I heard about the whole Harvest Moon publisher change situation. Parky. Is the Story of Seasons, is that pretty good? I haven't played it. The last Harvest Moon, in name or otherwise, that I played was A New Beginning, and like I said. I wasn't really super into it. I did like that you could, like, customize your character a little bit. I do wish you could... the annoying thing in A New Beginning... I guess it's sort of petty, but I really like the blacksmith. She's super cute, so I wanted to marry her. But I made a female character, and, you know, they're not ready to, you know, let you frickin' marry somebody. You know, you can't marry somebody of the same gender in that series. Or, you know, pretty much anything on freaking Nintendo. But, yeah. And it was so annoying because all of the dudes suck. Like, the only bachelor that was, like, kind of okay is the Super Tsundere guy, who sells you, animals. All of the other ones are just so lame. And, I mean, he's not really great. He's just kind of, like, the best of the worst. Are the new Harvest Moon, like, the Natsume Harvest Moons, are they, like, decent, though? Or are they, did they screw them up? I mean, in my opinion, they've been screwing up the actual Harvest Moons, too, so... I wasn't really sure if changing developers was going to make it better or worse. It's apparently a Harvest Moon that hack that lets you be gay. That wouldn't surprise me. But why would they make that, but not the just continue past 2 years? You'd think it would be simple. Oh well. Here's a tweet about the people defending the two fan games from the awards. Yeah, some... I don't know. Some people are just morons when it comes to any kind of fan content. Oh, by the way, these things are Scarfies. You might not think they are Scarfies, but... They are Scarfies. Do not try to inhale them. And I don't think there are... I don't think normal Scarfies are in this game, so those are just the Scarfies now. For this game, anyway. Get out of the way. Are there even any guys in the original Harvest Moon? I guess there's... No, there aren't really any guys with, like, any kind of amount of dialogue that would, like, make me think, oh yeah, obviously that one's gonna be one of the bachelors. All the guys are kind of useless, or they're, you know, just the fathers of the brides. Heard Story of Seasons is great. Ah, he fell for it. Yeah, this world really likes leaving traps. In fact, I think this level in particular pretty much always has a trap before your door. Yet another door troll. Oh, you were supposed to bring Needle! I don't know why you can't pop the balloon with a rock. I completely forgot about that one. This is one of those ones where the icon doesn't really, make me think of what I need to complete it. Because you need Needle. Did we even see Needle? Yeah, I think we did. But yeah, you need Needle to pop that thing. I think some other things might be able to pop it, depending on what ability it is. I love this level. Nice, rainy look. I just like the idea of having it start... Stardew Valley doesn't have a time limit, does it? I don't think it does. Oh, there's little fake Mario pipes in this level. Oh, you mean you dislike the idea of having a time limit in a Stardew Valley-like game. Oh. Yeah, the only the first Harvest Moon really has a time limit, though. At least a strong time limit. Like, some of the other ones, you need to do certain events before a certain time, or, you know, they won't occur. But it's not really a big deal. Unless you want to marry... There's a pretty com... If you want... Oh, I forget what it is, but in Harvest Moon 64, if you want to keep a certain character around and not I think Cliff leaves unless you do certain things. And I think he has to marry Anne or something if you want him to stay, which is stupid. So you can't keep him and marry Anne. And Anne is way cooler than he is, so I usually just married Anne instead. Stardew Valley must be completed in 2 years. Oh, it does? But other than that, huh. Okay, so it is kind of... I guess that's kind of... Usually Harvest Moon games will have some kind of, like, you're supposed to do this before, you know, that. But yeah, only the first one doesn't have any kind of post-game. What if babies keep being born and overcrowd the house? Oh no, it's this one. Ah! Oh, this guy is a jerk. Very tempted to save state. You know what? This guy, this is enough of BS that I'll save state. Okay, so... 5 of that, 2 of blue. Aw, oh, fucking. 4? Ah, it's 5. You know what? Whatever. Oh, it's the same pattern. Okay, so 5. I always count the 2 that he doesn't ask me for. Okay, 4 yellow and 4 blue. Oh no, it's 5 yellow! I always count the wrong ones. Does he do them in order or something? Okay, 5 yellow. No, I think it was yellow twice, so it can't be the colors in order. Oh, I didn't count those at all. Ugh! Is it the same with Animal Crossing? No, Animal Crossing doesn't have any kind of time limit. It has, it's real time, and, you know, if you want to do certain events, you have to play it around certain times of the year, but, you know, it's best of the clock. There we go. Yeah, Animal Crossing is not a game really about, you know, limits and punishing you and stuff. And Tom Nook has, like, the most ridiculously generous loan policies. Yeah, everyone hates him. It's ridiculous. Tom Nook did nothing wrong. I think you can bounce off of one enemy. I think you... Maybe you don't have to be running. All of the partners have little differences, which makes them pretty fun. But sometimes I forget them. I don't know why the Dreamland, especially Dreamland 2 and 3, I guess, did 1 even have any auto-scrollers? But I don't know why they do the auto-scrollers, they're never... There's a few in Superstar that are alright, but... A Dust and Elysian Tail should work on pretty much anything. Ah, that was too slow. They hate the fact that he forces dead on you? He doesn't, though! I mean... He fixes your house. I mean, if you don't want to pay, you don't have to. It's completely ridiculous to get upset at the debt that Tom Nook puts on you. Because, I mean, it's nothing. It's completely optional to pay. People are just tiny babies. So this is an obviously correct one. This is one of those ones where, you know, it's pretty clear who you need. Because Ku can fly against the current or whatever. What's... I guess it's not current when it's, you know, wind, is it? What would you say? Against the stream, I guess. Ow. I would really like an ability. Ah, not that. That's not an ability at all. This is actually a really bad one, but, Oh, this is a good one. This is a good one. Gimme. You don't play Animal Crossing because you've seen what it does to people. I mean, if you want to get everything, you know, it's pretty intensive. It's funny because it's casual, but it's also anything but casual. It's one of those games where if you want to do certain things, it's a very intense experience. What did Animal Crossing do to Zelda? Can it be cured? No, it cannot. Ow. Why did that hurt? Oh, whatever. Ah, no. Certain abilities can't attack forward, and that can be kind of annoying. This is another level that has Gourmet Race for some reason. I guess it's kind of fitting for the, you know, going fast theme. Ow. What? Oh. The Karakasa is a very odd boss to see in a Kirby game. I don't believe we need him. His power, rather. What? Wait, you just needed to beat that? Yeah, Animal Crossing, you could say that Animal Crossing is beaten either once you get the last home upgrade or you get the statue for paying off all debts. Somebody even does, there's some people that do speedruns of Animal Crossing, like all debts and 100%, which requires like some ridiculous bullcrap. Like what they do in Animal Crossing speedruns is for Animal Crossing the GameCube one. Ow. His attacks are decent, but not at all for this level. No, that's a Karakasa. It's a umbrella thing with a boot. Are these must be some reference to something, because they don't make any kind of sense. Yes! But yeah, the Animal Crossing thing, what they do is, they have to input these codes to get items, and then they clone things by putting They put like a chair on top of a thing and then they like clone stuff. It's hard to explain, but it's really glitchy and cool. I don't know, ninjas aren't really very unusual though. I would say the carrot cast is significantly more unusual to see than something like this. Also, you can kind of see how they're doing the parallax there. It's like four layer, or like, you know, it's different things moving at different rates, which, I mean, that's how parallax works, but I don't know, I'm trying to get at here. It's kind of neat when you start to get an eye for how some of these effects are achieved. I don't think there's actually secrets down there. This isn't Donkey Kong Country. Wait, what is your clean ability? Oh yes! It's beautiful is what it is. Wait, is this the Rick one? This is the Rick one. What am I doing? Yeah, it's Rick's girlfriend. Ow. Ow, what? The actions have to be pretty deliberate, especially attacks in this game. Hey, tooties. See, we have to get Rick. Rick, we gotta go find your girlfriend, Rick. Jeez, Rick, you're kind of the worst character for this level, Rick. Fortunately, we can climb out of the pits if we fall in as Rick, but he's... Yeah, this is the ability that we needed to dust off those plants with. There's at least usually something logical about what power combo that you need to achieve certain actions. Though some are very weird, like the guy that you have to have Choo-Choo slap in the face and he gets very excited. I'm not... That one seems a little questionable. Alright. Most of the inanimate objects you see in Japanese media are... I guess that makes sense. Hey, Dan. So yeah, this bit level is basically an obstacle course for Rick. Because Rick, it's all designed around Rick's wall climb. It's a lot easier without Rick, but the challenges, you know, are designed to make use of Rick for better or worse. Such as this jump where we have to bounce off this guy. Or actually, I don't think we have to, but it makes it a bit easier because we don't have to wall climb. Well, hitting him is harder, but... Oh yeah, and those jerks. Hold on. Okay. I was like, I don't want to do a blind jump here. It's a safe... It's a pretty... Oh. Never mind. It's not safe. How dare they put that guy there? That's rude. Okay. I see we're safe. There's Rick's girlfriend? Question mark? She's got a bow, so you know it's a girl. Cause I mean, there's... Obviously the pinkness is not enough. Or, you know, the fact that they're attracted to each other, whatever. I love that I haven't been showing off the squish... They have some good squishes of the animal friends when they, ready to do the jump thingy. Karakasa is just an umbrella. It usually has that boot thing too with a clog. So I think it's actually... Oh, this is a really cool level. You see these little drawings all over the walls. Those will be more interesting later. But the Karakasa... There's a game that literally translated Karakasa as umbrella boot, which is pretty fitting. Also, this is another gimmick of this level. I forget... I think this is one of those partner trade-off levels. I forget exactly how this one goes. This is a fun level. Ow. Oh. Of course this game has good squishes. Kirby is a good squish. There's something you need to do with partners. Is this whole game just a dream? No. Dreamland is kind of... Well, actually, I don't know what Dreamland is, because the world is called Popstar. But they called it Dreamland for a while. I guess maybe Dreamland is just a section of Popstar? Is there a certain partner I need for this? I'm gonna go with Nago, because they haven't used him very much. Aw, oh, come on. Don't play me like that. Right here, bro. There you go. I'm not sure if we'll have time for the true final boss in this tonight, but we'll definitely beat it at least, or like get to the end. I'll do... Wait... Oh, is this a painting level? I guess that makes sense with the crayon theme, doesn't it? Yeah, the animal friends are great. I wish they'd bring them back. Oh, yeah, he's the upside-down martini glass. I forgot about this one. So yeah, it doesn't require a specific animal friend. Alright, so... Was the base a little narrow? Or... like this. That's what it is, right? Or is he just upside down? Maybe... It usually does that sound when you do it right. I think maybe you have to do it upside down. Or possibly right side up, depending on your perspective. Ow. Oh, those don't have... Kirby has to be dizzy after Nago rolls him around a lot. Oh, right. Hey, Caldera. Or, oh, frick. Runny, or whatever you prefer to go as. I forget if you do this one upside down, or maybe I had it right before. Okay, there we go. Yeah, it's just, he's just upside down. Apparently Game Freak put the Shrug ASCII in... Oh yeah, it has lots of emotes for when you do the fake Pokemon Snap thing. I think Dreamland is just the portion of Popstar that goes through. Yeah, maybe. Nintendo likes those rooms where it looks intimidating, but you really just hold the run button. Oh, it's fine. Chatting's what chat is for. Oh. This is the puzzle. I really like this one. I like Superstar a bit more. I definitely like this one visually the most, though. See, the trick there is just that what door you go in doesn't really make sense. Do you ever use the helper AI? Not usually. I could have him just to show off how stupid he is, but... Are you even gonna swallow that gooey? It's rude to not eat things. Gooey. Gooey! They're starving children in Africa, gooey. For Pete's sakes. He's very helpful, as you can see. I usually don't bother with gooey unless...
You fucking idiot.
Yeah, gooey just made it so that I can't finish this room. Yeah, I usually don't bother with gooey unless I'm playing with an actual second player. Okay, now I will have gooey. Oh, here we go! Yeah, the drawings start to come to life. Gooey. No, whatever. Yeah, gooey is kind of standard. He's actually probably worse than the AI in Superstar, which is really bad. I think he does have some interesting stuff with how he uses his abilities, but he's so dumb that he never uses his freaking abilities, so... Well, thank you, gooey. He wanted to be useful just once. When did I start the live stream? I started about 42 minutes ago, apparently. It should say on YouTube. Somewhere on there it says when I or how long I've been streaming. Unfortunately, you cannot use gooey as a weapon. Here's Ice Dragon. Ice Dragon has appeared in 3 games, and he's only actually been, like, his real self in the first one, in Dreamland 2. Because he's a drawing here, and he's a hologram in Robobot. Oh, for Pete's sake, gooey. Oh, he actually did something right? Nice job, gooey. Never mind. Yeah, this is one of the better of the paint bosses. I think Robobot does the paint thing the best. But, this is a decent one. Paint Roller in Adventure is pretty weak. Also, was this guy in Dreamland 2, or is he just original character Do Not Steal? I forget. It doesn't seem familiar. Also, that one-eyed star is kind of creepy. I guess I can recreate another gooey. Gooey costs 1 life, and you can get 1 life back by spitting him back out. So if you only have half of a health, you can actually heal by 1 unit of health by making and consuming gooey. Gooey. Oh, there you go! That's sweet stuff from Ripplefield. Oh. Yeah, I just don't remember him. I played Dreamland 2 the least. In fact, I played it for the first time this year. Or beat it for the first time this year, anyway. Gooey. Ah, gooey! You can also heal gooey by eating him and popping him out. What pet blue? What are you talking about? Gooey? Gooey is the blue thing, if that's what you're asking. Ah, gooey! So freaking annoying. This is why I haven't been using him. Here is his one use, though. I just healed a health unit. Yeah, Mr. Shine, Mr. Bright. Power Classic. Uh-oh. I love the gooey heal. It's the one useful thing. Ow. Also, I love the painterly look on the clouds here, too. I'm not sure if it's a nod to Eido, or just, you know, because the game tends to have this style, anyway. And here's Krakow! Yeah, it is pretty cute when Eido gets mad. at the enemy loot or the painting losing. Hey, Daddy, Daddy. Do these? Nah, of course they don't. Usually, the paint bosses don't give you powers. I mean, usually bosses in general don't. A few do. Sometimes Krakow will give you beam, though. I think somebody asked last stream if Krakow was in this. He kind of is. Gooey is not exactly the best companion. The AI is pretty bad in this, and I mean most SNES games. You know, enemy AI is a lot easier because it's just trying to attack you. Trying to help you, that is a far taller order. Does Krakow get Kirby beam in the anime? I don't know, I haven't watched the anime myself. I've been meaning to get it. Ado's the girl in the back there. She's the, painter who is painting all the... these things to life? Ah. Apparently Krakow's two sides are supposed to indicate something like... apparently clouds have, like, poles. Oh, hey, Pepsi Man. Come here. Let's do a gooey heal. Unfortunately, the one boss where gooey heals are really useful is the last one, where you can't actually do a gooey heal. Or rather, the one place they would be really useful. Alright, get down to my level. Uh-oh. Ah! Krakow! There you go. Get out of here. Poor Ado. She's not actually much of a fighter. She tried. What is the plot of this game? I can just show it. Oh wait, did I show? Hold on, I want to show that intro. I forget if I showed it or not. I love these little... Psst. Gooey scaring the crap out of everyone. Also, DDD's new tower is, like, freaking creepy. There's a reason for that, though. I just want to show this one. Oh. Oh, no! Did I not show it? Hold on. I think if I exit the game... I think if I do a reset... I guess since you asked what the plot to this game is, I'll show you the intro. Ado will be fine. Hey, Annie. Ado will be fine. We just need to get the heart stars. Yeah, the plot is Dark Matter came. And I don't know if this is a different Dark Matter than 2. I love the little sweat drop. Planet Popstar is just like, aw, crap, not again. Not again. It's only been like 2 weeks. Wispy don't care. Waddle Dee cares, though. Gooey. Look how anime Choo Choo looks. Alright, I think if we start from the beginning... Yeah, here we go. Cloudy Park. Abandoned. Now you know what it's like, Kirby. Now you know what it's like. Alright, level 5. Dark Matter looks straight up evil as all hell. He looks even more evil later on, actually. It's pretty amazing. Hopefully we'll see that later tonight, but I'm not sure. Holy crap, this is Witch City. I like the frozen cactuses. It's an interesting level here. Like I said last stream, really good use of palettes. If you didn't really have a keen eye, you might not even notice this is a lot of the desert and cave texture stuff, but remade to like a frozen thingy. And yeah, Dark Matter is basically pure evil, so yeah, it makes sense for him to look evil. I think he's like made of pure hatred or something in the manual it says or something. I really wish they would give you the real manual text in the, when you, wait, do they even give you? Do they not give you a manual anymore for Virtual Console games? Or do you have to press this? Oh yeah, manual. But yeah, on PlayStation 1 games, when you play them on PS3 and Vita and stuff, it gives you a scan of the actual manual from the PS1 days, and it's really cool. But this is just, you know, this is just bleh. Like, this doesn't have any of the interesting stuff. It's just, you know, words. Nobody likes words. Ow. Oh, there we go. There we go. Delicious energy drinks. Kirby needs energy drinks to live. Oh right, I accidentally did this right. That's a nice change of pace. Oh right, and GUI will very often screw you up on things like this. This is one of the first, well not this one in particular, but one of these areas, GUI managed to ruin everything and like kill the plants because GUI is a terrible person. I'm not sure if this is a good one to have here. I think I'll just manually do these. But I want to keep pitch though, because pitch is great. Uh-oh. Okay. Okay, yeah, that's dangerous, because I'm pretty sure on the return trip, he can damage the things. So I'll just do this more carefully. There we go. Oops. Oh, I love the little ice sculpture things here. Oh wait, actually your ice isn't very good. I usually really like ice powers, but Pitch's ice power is one of his least good ones. Yeah, I enjoy a good manual. I was really impressed, I couldn't read it, but Senator Kagura Estival Versus has a really great full-color manual with little cartoons and everything. They did a really good job with that. That's pretty much just niche Japanese games that tend to have manuals these days, unfortunately. You like how even the intro to the level acknowledges GUI? Yeah, the intro to the game. Yeah, GUI is just dumb. Really up the enemy counts around here, huh? Ah, no! Bad bat. Look at that fire burb. Also, this node pushes you back a bit. You might see it. It's animated. Ow. Go away, bats. Naughty bats! Eat GUI instead. He's delicious. Ugh. My face. I need that. Alright. Ow. Ugh, you just had to go and do it, didn't you? Hey, buddy. Oh, I really love the snow here. It's like, it looks like ice shaving, like candy things. You can't see it very clearly while it's moving, but I guess if you want free items, you can always spawn GUI at the end. Also, it's kind of nice that GUI and Kirby and the animal friend will spawn here. Oh, oh, oh! Hold on. This is an important icon. also. I think we get that power in the level. You know what power will be important, though, don't you? Let's just eat gooey. Let me drop my bitrate a teeny bit and see if the frame drops improve. It's only 0.5%, and that's usually within acceptable condition, but I really wish Mediacom would fix the freaking crap. I never had this problem for like 2 years, and then it's just been constant. This level almost looks, Yoshi's Island-ish. It doesn't have quite the complexity, but the combination of the background and the foreground kind of makes me think of Yoshi's Island. I guess it's the sunset and the clouds. There's a backdrop in Yoshi's Island that's a little bit similar to this. Doesn't say anything about Dark Mine in the manual, really? Huh. Nago having legs? That's just wrong. Oh, here we go! I should really have more health for this. Do we have friends? Ah, here's friends. What are you just hanging out? That's actually probably a really bad one to have. I'm gonna need some range. Look at poor Nago. Popstar is a great place to live when, you know, nobody's, like, trying to destroy the entire world. Which is always, but, I could really use health. Okay. Okay. Gotcha! Yes, that is exactly what you think it is. Also, I think the embers are recycled snowflakes and recolored, of course. What was that cloud? That is not a cloud. If you mean these things, these are not clouds. I figured it would be pretty obvious, but maybe it'll be more obvious once we see who is at the end of this level.
No.
Okay, I think this is the last room.
Oh, no.
Oh, wait, they don't kill you?
No.
Go away. Those are some very passive Metroids. I figured they would hurt you. Maybe if you mash fast enough, they don't. Oh, no! Oh, whatever. Alright, give me your soul. Thank you. They think no one would notice? Those are original sprites. That's a reference. There's quite a few references in this game. This level just proves Kirby's the ultimate life form. I forgot they couldn't hurt him. Apparently bats are more dangerous. Kirby's bats are more dangerous than Metroids. Popstar is a very, very dangerous place. Everyone's just chilling while this giant wall of snow is about to crush everything. Bronto Burts seem pretty into it, in fact. Let's watch Gooey die. Oh, he didn't die. Oh well. Hey, Samus. So, according to this game, Kirby is about, I'd say, 2 to 3 feet tall. Because Samus is about 6-something. I guess 2 feet. The official size is 8 inches, but that doesn't make any sense because there's several humans in Kirby, and he's at least like 2 to 3. But yeah, the second level is usually a, there's kind of a pattern, if you'll notice. There's usually, a cameo. There's a girlfriend slash boyfriend thing. There's a plant thing. And there's a minigame. And the other ones are stuff like, you know, use a specific power and stuff like that. Oh, and I like the ice here. Yoshi's Island does some better ice, but it's not fair to compare most things to Yoshi's Island. It's pretty much perfect. Wall of smoke? That's an avalanche. That's snow. That's not smoke. You gotta remember, we're working with SNES stuff here. Is your firepower good? Not really, but we'll go with Nago. I guess Nago does have little... He has bumpy legs. I don't know what that means. This game has multiple cameos to some mostly obscure stuff. Samus is the closest to not obscure. Unless I'm forgetting something that's less. I think she's pretty much the least obscure. Though, I'm not sure how it was my... I guess, yeah, Metroid was pretty popular, wasn't it? At the time. I personally didn't hear about Metroid until Super Metroid. And I never had it until, Metroid Prime. I had Metroid Prime 2 first, actually. Ended up getting Metroid Prime 1. But, yeah. Yeah, Nintendo did lots of cameos around this time. Oh, this is an auto-scroller. I just noticed that. Don't dawdle too much, then. I'm not sure if Partner Gooey will ever eat a power. I think he might be programmed to not do that. He can get abilities, though, can't he? I thought he could. He can also die. He's very good at that. Oh yeah, Chef Kawasaki is in... Well, I guess there's only two that he's in, but, he's in Superstar too, so he was pretty common in this era of Kirby. I forget what the trick for this level is, or how to get the Heart Star. Is this just a minigame one? No, I don't think it is. Oh, I'll take that health. Thank you. You know, if Metroid's head invaded Popstar, you'd think Samus would be doing a better job than just, you know, sitting at the end of the level and waiting and, you know, hope some native life form wipes him out. Alright, this is a cruel one, because if you don't pick the character, you can let them fall. Which I will exhibit with Kine, because he's kind of, you know, he's Kine. Bye, Kine! Oh, maybe I shouldn't have... Wait. There's a, like, trading chain in the next... I think it's the next one. where we'll need, we'll get the cat back. I don't know if you can start that level with the cat. Oh, right, he just has a minigame, yeah. They love Gordos for these minigames. Damn it. Oh, look how sad he is. He's devastated. Oh. I like how Rick just kind of becomes a ball when you do that. Ow. Rude. Why does your ice take priority over my ice? My ice is clearly superior. Ow. Can you imagine what horrors would be if Kirby could swallow a Metroid and get a power? You know what? You made your minigame too hard, so you deserve to be sad. Also, Chef Kawasaki is usually larger than that, but oh well. Like I said, all of the... Oh, right. I had no idea what this one is. I always thought this was like a cake. But you'll see what it is later. Rick! I don't think you're very good for this level, Rick. Yeah, his name is Rick. Which is weird. The other two have... Well, Ku is kind of a questionable name. But, the other two... There's Kine. There's Pitch. There's no real theme with the names. They're just kind of all over there. Wait a minute. I think I might need fire. Fire is usually a safe bet in the ice world. Look how proud of Kirby is for landing. He's like, yeah, I landed, yeah, I landed, yeah, I landed, yeah! Oh yeah, here we go. I think I need you for the ability to go down and right with my fire. I haven't even gotten any Megastones yet in Sun Moon. I just got to the second island. Well, I just about to go to Route 5, so I'm a ways into the second island, but not super far. Do you have to do the battle spot for all of the... Like, isn't it battle points or whatever for all of the Megastones now? Sounds like it'll take a while. Does the Battle Mation equivalent cheat less in this one, or do we know yet? Birds. Ow! Yes, it's birds time. Ouch. Come on. No, 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 no! Oh, there we go. Ah! I thought I could go. And no, you can't. I can. No. No! You don't think you have to find Megastones in Gen 7. I thought you had to get them from the thing. I thought you had to buy them. At least I saw somebody talking about that anyway. I don't know. I'm not really too worried about that stuff yet. My only finalized members of my team are the Snorlax for because he's got the false swipe equivalent, and the Toucan, and who's not even a Toucan yet. And what am I trying to say here? What's his face? Dartrix, who I'm not letting evolve. I have 64 BP for each thing. Yeah, that's what I thought. This is another partner train thing. Hey, Soma Sam. Wait, pitch doesn't do it. We gotta use Choo Choo. They added new units to Totally Accurate Battle Simulator? Huh. They didn't email me about a new alpha. Oh, there we go. Sorry, Choo Choo. I used to think this was like a slice of cake. And if you think it is a slice of cake, your illusion will be abused very shortly. Ow. For Pete's sake, Choo Choo, I hate you. She's not great. Gooey, go. Gooey. I hate you so much, Gooey. I really do. Viku Volt, the water spider, the evolution. There's been some decent bug types lately. Huh? I think he needs his head to take damage or something. Get out of here. The horse seems overpowered. The frickin' defense on every death up every time you take a hit seems kind of ridiculous. Also, Kaboos look entirely like Moais and almost nothing like Kaboos now. Or in this game. Sun and Moon? Yeah, Sun and Moon seems good so far. It does a few things that are kind of dumb, but for the most part, yeah, it was actually a snail. As a kid, I never put two and two together, and I just thought it was some, like, lumpy dude who, like, really liked this cake and was just, like, being crushed by the cake. But yeah, it's a snail. But doesn't that look like a delicious cake? Each swipe of a Fury Swipe? No, I think it's just one per attack. But I don't know. I'm not sure why anyone would use Fury Swipe anyway. It's a bad move. Well, it's not that bad, but it's not good. The girl cat is really good. Oh, it does? Huh. Nah, if I don't, I'm gonna go back and get the heart stars once I, you know, when I'm gonna do, like, 0-2. I wouldn't go and gather the heart stars and then, you know, do a stream just for 0-2. I think there's something weird we have to do to get the cat. Or is it just that the cat isn't in this level? Is that the gimmick? How do you not see the cake? That is totally a cake. Or like a pastry thing. Ow. You have to get Nago from another level? Oh, alright. Is Nago on level 1? I think he might be. Yeah, let's go get Nago before we do that. I think that was the one I remember. Yeah, the animal friends are pretty devastated if you pick somebody else. Oh yeah, a double battle for Fury Swipes. That could be pretty useful, I guess. You don't see a cake or pastry? Oh, come on! Hold on here. Ugh, no images, stupid Google. I just searched Dreamland 3 cake instead of snail. Now, let me see if I can get a picture of his thing. Oh, I guess I can't. I guess it's his icon, so I'll find it there. Hold on. So, let me get some health before I leave this level. I don't want to start with less than full health. Cat Kirby. F-Zero SNES is all fake, Steve. You're actually stationary? The map moves under you thanks to Mode 7. Huh. Oh, I just realized why you're saying kind. It's actually... It's K-I-N-E, not that it really matters. I was wondering why you're saying, like, no in German. Okay, let me show you this. So this thing. Look at this. It's one of these things. Now, kinda is also no. It's kinda is no as like no and different. Bleh. Kinda is no as in amount. Nine is no as in negatory. The different words. Yeah, it's like a cinnamon roll but with like cherry stuff in it. It looks delicious. Good power. Wait, what is your... Oh, that's not gonna be useful. Neither is this one. Ow! Rude. Oh, did you see that juke? Denied. Oh, wait, actually, I think this one's a really good one. No, it's upwards. I guess these guys are just to trick you. These are Gordos pretending to be Boos from Super Mario World. Ow. Ah. Yeah, the timing on those things depends on when they're loaded in, so it's like pretty much always weird. Why didn't Kind get a counterpart? Kind doesn't get a counterpart. No, it's Koo! Koo that is the one that doesn't get a counterpart, but it's because there's only five worlds and there's six animal friends, and they only did one of those sort of levels per world. Hey Mew, by the way. I guess I'll get this. I'll also be Kirby, so I don't. No, here. Come on. Oop! Ow! No! Hate you so much right now, Gooey. I need to like unbind that button. Wait, can I inhale? No. Gooey ruins everything. See, this is why I was not using Gooey. Sorry, guys. sick. I thought I could make it. Eat it, Gooey. Gooey. What the hell are you doing, Gooey? You had one job, Gooey. You freaking idiot. That's what you're supposed to do. Oh yeah, in Fallout, aren't the toilet rolls the wrong way? They're facing the wall. Yeah, I'd heard that somebody made a mod to fix that. Ugh, we're kinda low on health. The Eldritch Horror, Kirby. I just love Nago's face in that. Like I said, there's so many good faces the animal friends make. Really great animation in general in this game. Ugh. This camera, I don't like when it gets stuck on when you're like 3/4 of the way to the right, and it's like, nah, I'm not gonna scroll yet. Oh yeah, that's, I don't need that. The eyes when gerbils, oh yeah, when, ow. I forgot Nago is extra tall. Yeah, when Rick uses the spike thing and Kirby's like, ow! Oh, right. I forgot they changed direction. Well, I guess just that one does. Okay, this is very dangerous. I don't need a one-up, I need health. Ah, for Pete's sake. Please reach the end or give me some health. Oh no! I think these things are gonna jump out and attack. Oh no, they respawn? How dare they respawn? What the frick? Oh. Get me out of here. Oh wait. Gooey! Gooey is useful for once. Oh, that thing is so freaking creepy. See ya, Daddy. Welcome back, Dan. This is a pretty fun one. It's my second favorite on SNES after Superstar. Oh right, I think this guy shows you a secret. Or does he? Maybe he's just here to tease you. That's a Batamon. It's kind of funny, they're super creepy in this game, but they're... oh no, he's just there to troll you. This level tries so hard to guilt you into picking anything but Nago. Oh, come on. Get... There you go. Oh, no. I just want this level to end. I have so little health. There we go. Hey, Kirby. I know you're not doors. Also, if you eat those things, you actually take damage. Oh no. Wait. Okay, now we're fine. I'm falling for your tricks. Yeah, I see you. I see you. Ow! I really don't want to lose Nago, because then I have to do all of this again and get Nago first. Yeah, you can keep those stars, my Sharky friends. Aw, for Pete's sake. Stupid Kappas. Unfortunately, most projectiles can be deflected by your own attacks in this game. That thing looks wrong. You mean the attack? Yeah, it's pretty creepy. goodness. These things are cute too. They hide with little bits of the backdrop. This is a freaking long level. All right. No pictures? There should be pictures of Batamon. Look at that vase! Nago doesn't care. Or maybe he really does, but we can't tell. What beautiful legless cats. Oh, too late for that. They just wanted to see each other. Nice little Tetris background there. I forgot about that one. Unfortunately, we don't have too many things to get. Aw, yes! Really like that song. This level is pure jerk, so I think I'm just gonna save state. I think there's some point where we... Ow. Where one of these leads to a thing. Oh, is this just Moss Tower? Oh, right! You gotta... Ah. I remember this one. Yeah, Wii U Virtual Console finally lets you do save states. You just have to get the power that it wants you, that it shows you, I think. Ow. I think from now on, you just need to get whatever ability the mid-boss has. Yeah, Kirby pretty much always has mid-boss tower. Aside from the first game, which didn't have mid-bosses. There we go. I like how perturbed Ku looks if you try to have him fly with Kirby's rock. Got the mini NES to play the original Kirby. It's actually not the first Kirby game, it's just Kirby's Adventure. Dreamland for, ow. For Game Boy is the first. You can play Kirby's Adventure if you have anything Wii, or 3DS. NES Mini is kind of questionable value, in my opinion. I mean, it's alright if you don't overpay. Like, if you pay retail price, it's not bad, but it's not like... I don't really think it's super amazo, like a lot of people seem to think. NES isn't really my era of games, anyway. If it was an SNES and it had, like, a ton of stuff, sure. I guess it did have those two, but definitely didn't have a mid-boss tower. Actually, oh, frick. I'm just gonna save here because I forget Yeah, it wants whatever the latest power is. It's kind of rude, frankly. So you have a completely reasonable reason to think that the mid-boss power would be the one. If NES Mini had original cartridge compatibility, then I would say, and the Sega ones do. Sega has plug-and-play things that do have original cartridge support, I think. Yeah, SNES Mini. Now that I would purchase. I'm gonna dust your fire off. Yeah, there's kind of too many grim descriptions in Sun Moon, in my opinion. It just kind of loses all of its impact. It's just like, yeah, everything is gonna die, and it's also gonna kill you, and other things are gonna kill it, and blah blah blah, whatever. It's like, if you do that with one or two entries per generation, it has a really nice impact that makes certain Pokemon seem like really, you know, dang. But when it's like every freaking Pokemon, it's like, just calm down, really. I'm sorry, my spiky friend. Pokédex description, dude is going through some hard times this gen. That's a way to look at it. And I think they just kind of try and... It's really obvious in Sun Moon that they're trying to be like, yeah, this one's different. This one's, you know, if you didn't like the last ones, this one's so good. It's like, it's all different and stuff. But then it has fucking Zubats everywhere. It's like, the one thing, I would very earnestly enjoy them just not having Zubats everywhere, but they still put Zubats everywhere. Poor creepy DDD. We could use a better ability for this. Ku's pretty good for this, but... Wait, is this? Yeah, that'll be great. Oh man, all Chef Kawasaki, I should have done a save state. I figured I would screw up more than just that one level. Something seemed a little off about DDDD, anybody else? That's just my imagination. Huh, what an easy final boss fight. Good old DDD. Oh. Here comes the fun stuff. That's gotta hurt. Where's the good one, though? I wonder how many nightmares this game gave little kids. Oh, come on, do the fun one! Yes! Look at his eyes snap open. That frame is the only time DDD appears to be awake. And it's probably because of the pain. In fact, he does that when he's hurt too. So you can tell it hurts when his stomach opens. Oh, do it one more time, DDD. Oh, come on, DDD. Oh, come on, why aren't you doing it? Classic. They've done that a few times in other Kirby games too. Poor DDD. Yay! We won! Oh, and I love the drawn look of the spring breeze backdrop. Oh, that is Scarfy. He just has a pig face now. I thought maybe it was a different thing. I actually really like this enemy credits thing, that we get to see all the names for the things. I guess we should have enough time to get the rest of the heart stars, since we've got save states, and then we'll see the true final boss. DDD is a bad guy on his own will a few other times. Usually not the major antagonist, though. It's a really nice hint that the wallpaper background looks really fake. Deckaboo. Loud! Just Loud. That's a good name. Baby Ridley. Chili. Who's actually Frost, isn't it? Or is he Chili? I think Mr. Frosty is the... Oh, it's the little penguin dude! Oh, Peldo is the creepy dude. I'm thinking of Mr. Frosty, the butt guy. Yeah, Deckaboo, that's a pun in Japanese. Deka is like big. Or no. Is it? Or something like that. Bobu. Captain Stitch. I forgot about Hadaboki. I guess we just fought Hadaboki, didn't we? Jumper Shot. Which. Karakasa, but whatever. Did I eat the game? Yes, I have eaten the game. It was delicious. And... I love that. You didn't really beat the game, did you? Alright. Back in. So, this one should be easy. Unfortunately, we do have to rebeat the bosses too, but whatever. Oh, and rip to our, like, 40 lives that we had. But it doesn't really matter. Just do your thing, Mr. Penguin friend. Did I beat the game? Technically, you could say. You know, it's a bad ending, but, what's ice for him? Oh yeah, I remember, it's... I guess we'll go with him. We just need to beat the minigame this time. I'm just gonna use save states just to make sure that we get finished in time. I don't really... There's a couple other things I want to get to recording tonight, so... I don't want to waste too much time, you know, proving my elite gamer skills. I just want to show off 0-2. Or 0-1. Normal. Just plain old regular 0. But yeah, we're gonna... That shouldn't take too long. Like I said, I think there's only like maybe 4 or 5 heart stars that I'm missing total. Oh! Yeah, just start scrolling exactly the wrong time, thank you. Kirby looks so mad when he's running in this game. It's actually been very common for Kirby to have separate endings. Either... Actually, pretty much every Kirby game since Superstar Ultra has had either an alternate end... Every mainline Kirby since around, I guess, Dream Land 2 and 3 has had some manner of hidden ending. And in this game, what they do is they hide all of the grim stuff beyond the harder difficulty, or you know, the 100% completions, you know, the little kiddos, the tiny babs do not see the horribleness. Not that there's anything horrible at the end of this game, there definitely isn't. There's no like child scarring, you know, horrible monstrosity at the end of this game. You know, it's just a happy Kirby game. Also, when Kirby spits out an air puff, it's his face is on it. Have you seen that? How do I? Wait. Ugh, this is so hard to pause it like this. But just watch. Ugh, no. Resume. I hate when you get like two layers of stupid crap on screen. Kirby's air puff has an angry Kirby face on it, if you haven't noticed that. Which is a cute little touch. But yeah, it's hard for me to freeze frame at the right time. Well, I can't really freeze frame the thing. Wait to select? No, that just spits out your power, doesn't it? Some SNES games would have, like, select would pause, or start would pause and bring up the menu, but select would just pause and, like, you know, leave the screen blank. Amazing Mirrors were the bad ending stop? Well, kind of, but the way Triple Deluxe, they hide extra story behind either the deluxe mode or whatever, because there's extra stuff in Robobot and Dreamland, or Return to Dreamland and all of that. Like, the boss descriptions are very important in Robobot, if you haven't noticed, in hard mode. And yeah, there's extra, even in the secret, or the, whatchamacallit. Oh, we haven't shown off Kine's. Kine has the best freeze. True Arena has some interesting stuff in Robobot. Some very tragic, interesting stuff. He just becomes frozen fish. So good. He becomes the freezer section of your local Walmart. Oh, right. Alright, you know, we're just gonna go full cheat. Don't even care. Alright, easy. I think that was this. Oh, frick! Thanks for the follow, more David. So does Kirby have a series have some horrifying stuff hidden away? Alright. Fire. Hold on a sec. Alright, easy one. Yeah, Kirby has some pretty messed up stuff. It depends on the game. But Dreamland 3, 64... and pretty much all of the recent ones have at least something pretty screwed up. Yeah, I did do an article on that. Let me link that. Come on. Yeah, that has major spoilers for Kirby stuff, but it also shows you some of the horror stuff. Though you should probably just wait for the true end of this game before you read that article. It's not necessarily like Silent Hill stuff, but there's some very depressing stuff in Robobot and some pretty kind of violent stuff in this one. It's mostly the fact that it's really the contrast that makes it most significant, but it really makes an impact. It makes a better impact than a lot of horror games, in my opinion. Yeah, the final boss of this game will give you a good hint at what Kirby likes to do as a series. Yoink. Aww. All now I have to beat up DDD again, I guess, which I think will end the game again. Kind of annoying that you have to wait for. This is actually really terrible. Well, most of Kind's abilities are really terrible. Oh! Oh, never mind! Oh. Okay, it has the potential to be cheap. But usually you just get hurt. Okay, this isn't working. Gooey. Need to eat your flesh. Gooey's delicious flesh will save us. Strangely enough, the series last used a violent image perfectly with the game rather than be shocking back in the day. Which latest use do you mean, though? Because Robobot was more depressing. Robobot was more tragedy than horror. Sorry, DDD. Oh, I guess I should have beat him last, because I think we have to beat him. I think we'll have to beat him a third time. But at least we get to be his friends now. Oh, yeah. Yeah, the Triple Deluxe. Yeah, the Triple Deluxe thing was a surprise. I didn't really figure they would use blood again. But I guess it wasn't enough to get an ESRB rating. Or a higher ESRB rating. Alright, yeah, that's not the true ending yet. We, still have to clear the other two areas. I guess I should have done that last, but... Oh, it was such an easy fix. All right, we have two here. Wait, hold on. What? How many do we have missing on level three? Why does DDD have Satan in his chest? That's dark matter. We're beating the crap out of Gooey. Oh, right. This stupid thing. Yeah, this level drove me mad. I'll just use save states. I'll use them earlier this time, too, because I think I saved too late or something. Man, this is not a fun puzzle. Also, spiders everywhere. This is a fun but very impractical and not very good ability. Let's go with Rick. The benefit of Rick's thing is that it doesn't actually have to have a snowball hit something to deal damage. If they're close enough to you, they just take damage. But if you see more Kirby stuff, you'll find that poor DDD tends to have a lot of bad things happen to him. Squish. I love how those things, the ticks play, innocent. Are they called tricks or ticks? Both would make sense, so it's hard to... Uh-oh. Look at those fancy spikes! They got little curly cues and everything. I knew you're there. Ow. Ah! I still got hit! There you go. I'm not falling for your charade. Gradius nod. I'll have to take a look at that. Literal embodiment of evil's true form. Yeah, that's pretty much it. What was the order for this stupid thing? Let me just... that was not a useful search. Let's just do heart stars. This is level 3, right? Or world 3. Where's that little cave dude?
Halfway through the stage of his
path. First hit the lower, then middle, then middle. Okay. I swear I did this before though and it didn't freaking work. Aw, come on. What is this middle crap? There's no middle here! What do you mean middle? There's no middle! That was not middle. Whatever. And now I'm stuck because Rick is kind of slow. Huh? Oh, boss time, I guess. Please. Yes! Alright. I like this background. Even though it was clearly not designed to be used like this, it looks pretty nice. Donby? Yeah, who is this a reference to? It's some kind of NES. Game that I don't know. Oh yeah, I stand by my position that Kirby Planet Robobot is the best Star Fox game of 2016. Was it 2015? That was... I don't know, years are blending together. I just want this year over, that's all I know. It really hasn't been that bad for, at least for my channel anyway, though. It's been a great game for years, it's been a great game for years, yes, that's words. That's how you words. Danbei from Shin Onigashima? Huh. There we go. I guess these one-ups really don't matter, but whatever. Panincon. Wait, I'm not sure if this will hurt. Or get me hurt. It is! Perfect! This is like OP against these things. Yeah, that's an NES sprite, I guess. From whatever that game was that someone mentioned. Huh? What the? Why did he roll backwards? Dance on your graves. It's funny because the heart star thing implies that, like, you know, everything's fine after you beat them, but they still freaking explode. Because I think you visit them again. Aren't they like friends if you visit them again? Let me try that. Look at Rick! He's so cute! Yeah, they're just little, they're just happy friends. So these ones just kind of diddle around. But look how cute Rick is when he looks forward. Now that I remembered that, let's take a look at the other ones. I think you do have to fight DDD again if you do that. Yeah, Wispy is just like, I'm just gonna climb your face, Wispy. I just noticed Popstar's rings are broken in the thing. So it's consistent. Let's see what Acro does. Kind of waddles around. Alright, last world, or last world to get heart stars from. We actually need Rick for this one too. Not this power though. This one. Best, strongest ability. We're gonna dust out crime. Kinda disappointed the mechanization of Robobot didn't stick around. That would be a bit much. Especially considering what happened to certain important characters. They did say that the Dream Leaf, or the Dream Petal, or the Dream Stalk stayed. So there is still a canon, and there's still, Dreamland is permanently affected by things that happened. Some things that happen anyway. I'm not sure if I lose. No, I don't. There's a later chance to get that, I think. You just have to make sure you have Rick. Ow. He just looks amazed by life. I guess having some parts left in metal would be maybe interesting, but it seems like one of those situations where they kind of just had to, you know, dial it back to happy ending, everything's reversed. Wait, did we get Rick in this level? Or was me losing Rick very bad and unfortunate? Speaking of very bad and unfortunate. Auto-scrollers. Oh, hello. Rip, bottom on. Pretty freaking sure we need Rick. I thought he shows up in here. Hey there. Sorry, I see chat messages. At least from Twitch, I see chat messages super late. Oh, come on, he's gotta be somewhere here, right? Here somewhere. Words. Who needs him? I like how in this version of the ducking sprite, it seems like Kirby has to expend continuous effort to keep himself squished down. Rest in peace, Bottomon. He was a true hero. Can you ever even attack Bottomon? I think there's one Bottomon you can hit. Maybe. How do you words? I don't know. I've been here on this earth 26 years and I still don't know how to words. I don't think it's important. There we go. Wait. But I need Rick. Where do I get Rick? I think you get Rick early on here, right? These clouds look delicious, by the way. out-eat the heck out of one of these clouds. You can kill them with Peach's spark ability. Oh yeah, you can. You can do that, but I mean, I was wondering if you'd like go to inhale them. Oh, did you just recently learn English? That's cool. I learned German in high school. And just small amounts of Japanese and very small amounts of Japanese and Spanish. We had like a Spanish class for like a month in grade school. I don't even know what the point of that was. I guess we just have to keep Rick.
Morty, we gotta dust the flowers, Morty. It's important, Morty. Don't ask questions, Morty.
Yeah, Broom Hatter's neat. Poor Broom Hatter finally got an ability after like 4 Kirby games. And then they take it away from him again, and we never get abilities from Broom Hatter ever again. He's one of the OGs, and they just such disrespect. You gotta be careful. Ow. This is just such a powerful ability. It's hard to contain yourself. And you know, so you take some damage just because it's so powerful. I mean, look at this. These poor enemies. I feel sorry for the enemies this happens to. It's just, it's not a good way to go. I think you've forgotten every bit of Spanish. Yeah, pretty much. Broom Hatter's a meme. Since when is Broom Hatter a meme? Broom Hatter is Broom Hatter. Oh no. Okay, I think there's some food around this area. Oop. Spider? That's not food. Spiders are not food. Uh-oh. Now I need food even more. You know what? I'm just gonna use the gooey thing. Gooey! Gooey is alive for a quarter of a second, and he still manages to throw my power away for no reason. What a friend. What a bro. Uh-oh. Oh wait, is there food up here?
Yes!
Oh, huh. It's kind of funny though, because Broom Hatter is in a secret. He's usually in the Howl rooms. Or he's in some of them. I think he's in the first Howl room. And he's in some of the more recent Howl rooms too. Oh. Rick can't eat from the top of his head. Unfortunate. Wait, what even is Rick's electric? I guess I'll never know, because all these things keep dying. Yeah, the way we learn languages at least in the US, is really dumb. There's something called the critical period. I forget exactly when, but it's fairly early on where it's easiest to absorb new languages, especially phonemes. And we teach languages way, way too freaking late to take advantage of that. And it just means it takes vastly more effort to really keep it up. So we just kind of screw over our kids in that department. And it sucks. Okay, so, and this thing, this one's trickier because you have to not crush the flowers because of the stuff going in front of your face. The clouds. Oh yeah, I forgot that, yeah, it's beam, which I just saw there. But I think you can squish those. Yeah, that was close. Rick, you gotta be careful around these flowers. I don't know, Rick. Oh my gosh, I just had a very small heart attack. Okay. Alright. The only alt codes I remember are the trademark and copyright symbol because of the X-Bone. The stream froze for a sec when you were right above it. Perfect timing. Alright, chicken. What was the chicken? What was chickens? Oh, we need needle. We need needle. Alright. Super secret final boss is coming up pretty soon. And by super secret, I mean the game strongly suggests that it exists and is not really particularly secret. I guess it's boss is, isn't it? So, I guess it doesn't matter which one we use for this. I just need needle. Wherever the heck needle is. Needle is in the stage, right? So I don't think I'm gonna break it with this, with my dusting. Let me tweet that I'm about to reach the final boss. Ow. What hit me? Alright. I should probably set the... well... I don't know how I would automate, hey, I'm about to reach the final boss, but I should automate some sort of, like, reminder as well. Like an hour into the stream or so. Oh wait, I think Cutter might work? I'm not sure. I'll grab it since we don't have Needle anyway. We're about to find the secret boss, my stream dies. Stream is up. Stream's still up. I might have dropped a few frames, but uh-oh. Rick is happening. Now, where's the freaking needles? Rick is outrunning Kirby. Oops. I was just saying that because somebody said, I wasn't sure if somebody knew. Do we get Needle in this level or not? I'm questioning this now. Oh, no. Oh, you have potato internet? Alright. First they're making YouTube videos on potatoes, now they're making... live streams. What a time to be alive.
Oh!
Alright, let's eat gooey. I can't believe I'd forgotten about the gooey thing. Alright, Needle time. Never one of my favorite abilities, honestly, Needle. They kind of improve it Return to Dreamland when they give it full abilities, but they give it multiple attacks, rather. Oh, Dune is very good. I enjoyed the whole series, but it definitely gets crazy and, you know, very different. I even enjoyed the prequels done by the Sun and the other guy. At least I enjoyed the Butlerian Jihad. Very different, but we saved the little burb. He's so happy. All right. That is the last heart star. Why couldn't you break the balloon? You have a beak. That's like Needle. Oh, whatever. Nice. But yeah, Dune's really good. The first one is the one people usually point out as a classic, but there's a lot of other crazy stuff. Anyone with a personal crazy story about Black Friday? Oh yeah, did anybody go to Black Friday? Or like, do crazy shopping or anything? I actually forgot that it was Black Friday, and then after I remembered it was Black Friday, I just decided that no, I'm making it a point to forget that it's Black Friday, and I didn't buy anything. Ain't nobody got time for that. I mean, if you got cool deals, I mean, sure, but personally, I have too many games already, so like, I don't really need to buy things. Are there more books than Dune? I'm not sure if that's a snarky joke, but yes, there's like 6 books in the original Dune series, and then there's a bunch of prequels done by his son. I think there's also something that's like made together from his notes. I'm not sure if that's the sun stuff. No Black Friday for your nephew. Yeah, I did in-person Black Friday once with my mom. I forget what we even bought, if it was even anything, like, worth it. It wasn't too bad, though. I think we did late Black Friday shop. Like, it wasn't first day stuff. Or first hour stuff. So, like, I remember the stores being, like, creepily empty. It was, like, creepy. Poor Ado. She tries. She really tries. She really puts her heart into it. Heart of a champion! That's why you gotta get the whole family tricked out in riot gear and storm the place in defensive formation. But yeah, there's some hardware stuff I could look into, but really, the only hardware I was too interested in was the PlayStation 4 Pro, and I found there was an Amazon warehouse deal, and I just went for that. I just decided, you know what? I don't even want to care on Black Friday.
Little brother.
Oh, we don't have to beat him again. Okay. So yeah, on to the true final boss then. Hyper Zone. What do you mean revisit this one? I probably will look for some Cyber Monday stuff, but I don't know. Oh, good music time. Well, it's always good music time with Kirby, but... pay particular attention to the music when this boss gets beaten. It's not even spoiling anything that a Kirby final boss has a second form. I mean... original DDD is like one of almost, like, extremely few that doesn't have a second form. That's right, Parker! This is one of his more annoying ones, because he can't really deflect it. Ah, Parky! Parky! Not now! Parky! Please. Parker. Ow! Yeah, see, that's what I mean. Alright, watch. Oh, wait. Alright, good stuff. The Doesn't that just give you chills? I love that drop in the music. And yeah, Zero is fantastic. He's one of my favorite bosses of all time. He's just so like, what the hell? And then flings blood at you, directly at the player. And when he... Oh. Ow. I gotta be careful. Oh yeah, Sorry, I will do the revisit. I'll have to do that after we beat the final boss. But yeah, thanks for reminding me. I guess I should visit DDD then, too. I thought I'd have to fight DDD. So yeah, I need to revisit both of those, Ado and DDD. So heat makes dark matter, apparently. It's gonna be close if I even win. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. I was talking about nightmares earlier, and I really want to know how many nightmares this upcoming scene caused. Not quite yet. This isn't even the worst. Oh, no, 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 no.
Okay, we're good. I'm good.
Come on.
Do the thing! No!
Fuck. Okay. Alright. We'll be good this time. Parker's not- Ah! Parker! Oh, for Pete's sake, Parker. I was just about to explain that you wouldn't get me hurt this time. Yeah, Parker's on my desk now.
Ugh, excuse you.
Yeah, it kind of helps to be under him. I think he can shoot up. I'm not sure if he can shoot down with that attack. Ow, really? I can't believe I got hit by that. The best part, we haven't even seen the best part yet. It's gonna be okay because Parker won. Parker! Yeah, that's pretty much Parker in a nutshell. Alright. Bye bye. I love that flicker. That, like, what? That really gets you. But he has one more trick up his sleeve, and it's absolutely fantastic. So definitely keep your eyes peeled, so to speak.
So much health.
Just casually bleeding all over you.
Ugh.
I forgot that you couldn't hurt those. I like the musical, I like the effect of Zero's theme a lot better. The music drop and the flicker when he spawns in, I think that's way more effective than Zero Two. But just as music, I like Zero Two's a bit better. Alright, keep your eyes open. Now, and watch him, not me. Oh, yes! I wonder how many kids had horrible nightmares after that. And he just flays around you and tries to make you panic. He doesn't need a body. Can you only hurt him with the stars, not the swipe? There you go. And he sprays blood everywhere and pops. Kirby's just happy as can be. I miss these old pixel art cutscenes. You don't really see, like, too many indie games try to do the, you know, the pixel art cutscene thing. Friendship! And now everybody's happy and... Look at DDD's face! Like, huh? She's just drawing a circle. This is really cute. Credit sequence. Oh yeah, and we'll go back and see the revisit scenes for DDD and Ado. His acro blue. See you soon, Sam. How is Kirby not scarred for life after fighting that? He fights even more. I'm not sure I would say anything is worse than Zero, but he fights some stuff that's almost on par. Ado. It's pretty strongly suspected that Ado just actually is Adeline, the character from Kirby 64. Because, I mean, they're basically the same, and Ado doesn't appear again, so it's probably just, you know, a rename. Choo-choo given those eyes. Oh my. Little pitch. Super Mario Club. What is Super Mario Club? Rick! We gotta save Dreamland, Rick! Oh, I'd forgotten about the credit sequence you get after Boss Butch. I'm not sure I'll want to do that tonight. Friends. That's my favorite one. Just friends. Let me see if I can find just a video of the Boss Butch credits, because I don't really want to do that tonight. Mute that. Oh, he doesn't watch the credits. How dare you? Boss Butch is the boss rush mode. I have no idea what's called that, unless it's like boss butchery. It's kind of grim for a Kirby game. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Okay, I'll show it after we see the Alright, this is actually the end, so. Now we'll do the revisits. The Boss Butch is kind of fun, though. It has different... I guess I'll show you the start of it. But it has little palette swaps of all of the bosses. Also, it has really good game over. So I'll show the Boss Butch game over real quick. Does the GUI trick work? It does not. Kirby's the best version of Cell from Dragon Ball Z. KO'd by an eggplant. I guess they're different for each, whoever defeats you. Hi there. Hey, Artie, or whatever your name was, sorry. Hold on. I just realized he's spitting eggplants in that version, too. Hold on, there's... some other things I want to show you real quick. Alright, first, let's see the revisit scenes for DDD and, Ado. Ado lives in a giant strawberry cloud. How awesome is that? Hey, Ado. What are you drawing? Oh my. I had forgotten about that! Is that all she draws? Also, how do you draw in, like... Ah, oh, she draws cake! Let me see if I can find that game over screen I meant to. Alright, is it just those two, or... Oh, she draws a Game Boy! I don't think I ever revisited Ado. Let's see if I can find that. Does anybody have that game over when you lose to Zero and Boss Butch? It seems Ado rather likes Kirby. I can't believe Ado stole this cake in Squeak Squad. Oh yeah, Ado and Kirby 64, she does draw that thing that it gets like glitched or like it's a lot of like pixelated. Oh, is that all he does? Hold on. Parky, please get down. There you go. Let's see if I can find this. There's a really good picture of the Game Over and Boss Butch. I think I have it somewhere. No? Oh, there you go. It's in the chat. Thanks for that. You'll see it in the stream, yeah. So one last thing. I want to show, how am I going to do this? Monitor capture. Yeah, let's see. No, you go over here. No, go over. There you go.
Quality.
Oh, I was talking over it. So yeah, this is the ending. She draws an X, huh? Oh, it's anime DDD. DDD is trying to block out the memories of possession by Satan himself. I guess they are a little bit more realistic style. This is the YouTuber that started Broom Hatter? It is? Who even is this? Meteor XXX? Oh, I hadn't heard of him. Yeah, I think I beat Boss Butch once. I think I did it on the Wii version. So I didn't... Huh. Ado looks kind of weird like that. Or Arco. There's Ado. Is it Ado or Ado? I guess we haven't really heard it spoken aloud to know either way. You are seeing this properly, right? I mistakenly put OBS on the same screen that I'm doing the display on. But yeah, they do kind of look more realistic. It's still in the game's art style, though. He does a series categorizing what Kirby canon is. Whoa! Whoa. That's kind of unsettling. These drawings are supposed to be by Edo? Oh, I guess that could make sense. But yeah, that coup was intense. Like, I don't know. Aw, and Pitch is still cute. Pitch is like super fluff. Look at that. That is a very good burb. That is A+ burb. I give that. That is a good burb. Rick with feet! That's too realistic. No, that's those feet. I can't deal with those feet. I can deal with Pitch, though. Oh, God. Gooey, that's... Oh, right! Gooey is dark matter, by the way. Gooey is dark matter, and if you bring Gooey in, he actually has the little spheres around him while he flies. Oh, and there's dark matter. Oh, so that's what this is from. And here's frickin' Zero. Glaring at you with his, like, blood sockets open. Yeah, that Gooey. Honestly, the Gooey was creepier than Zero. But yeah, Gooey is canon dark matter. I think that's from the menu or the manual in Dreamland 2. But yeah, Gooey's just actually dark matter. All right. So put this over here. Back to Elgato. Is Box Punch Game Over by Edo 2? Maybe. But yeah, it turns out Gooey is actually terrifying. Actually, let me see if we can connect a different controller so you can see this. Where's my batteries? I got a Wiimote that doesn't have batteries. Hold on. If you leave batteries in a Wiimote, they'll just die, so I always take them out, is my pro tip. I don't know what Wiimotes do that eats batteries while they're completely off, but it sure does it. And, oh, that battery is dead anyway. Good stuff. I hate non-rechargeable batteries. Okay, is there life in this one? Well, I use rechargeable, like, whatever they're called. Rechargeable double A's, but they don't have the good battery life either. Alright, controller. Spoop that in there. How do I even... Hi, Luke. Hi, Dan. What did you say? Why did it take Nintendo to learn so long to learn about rechargeable batteries? Yeah, because it made their stuff cheaper. Sounds about right. Plus, I mean, have you seen how badly everything but the Wii U Pro controller does with batteries? Oh, here we go. What did I do? Here we go. Yeah, he's Kirby, Oh, look at his eyes, by the way! Look at his frickin' eyes! When he spits out the star. Something is not right with Gooey. But yeah, Gooey is canon dark matter. And, I'm not sure what happens to him at the end of this game, but... He seems to be good? Question mark? Dark matter? Tiny Kirby. Once 50 peoples are watching. Oh. It's one of those. Hold on, I have something special for people like that. Where are we? Oh, I have too many windows open. Hold on. No, I have this somewhere. Boop. Okay. Gooey needs a doctor. Gooey exploded in a big fiery ball that was visible from space. Some people say that Gooey turns into the dark matter of Kirby 64. I don't know. The thing is that those just seem like we saw with Zero, he can just spawn more dark matters. But speaking of Gooey exploding, well, that sounds good. So let's just see that. Oh, Kirby went first. He overcame his devil mind. Yeah, I'm gonna... I'm gonna go ahead and stop streaming here. Thanks for watching, everybody. And that was real fun. That was Dreamland 3. And I don't know what we'll play next. I'll see if I can play with a pen on... with emulating Canvas Curse. Because I do have... With my Surface Pro 3, I could potentially play with a proper pen instead of just an awful mouse. So I could play it without having to rebuy it. Put up a poll. I guess I could put up a poll. I'm kind of running out of games, though. At least games that I have that I can play without an emulator. I do have Kirby's Adventure. I guess Return to Dreamland. I did stream Return to Dreamland a couple years ago, but I wouldn't mind doing it again. I also have... I guess there is there's Rainbow Curse, too. Yeah, I guess I could put up a poll. That's a good idea. But yeah, thanks for watching, everybody. Have a good night. And try not to, like... Don't let the cybers eat you on Monday. I'm pretty sure that's what Cyber Monday is.